What up, peeps? Welcome to a game hunting road trip video. Super excited. This is Cody.
Nice to meet you.
Pinkarilla. You guys probably know him, DS Koopa on Twitch. There'll be links in the description so you can go check him out. But so we are taking this road trip and you are live streaming basically the whole thing.
That's right. I reached out to my viewers a couple months in advance and said, hey guys, what are you looking for? We accumulated a list and now we're going to do a virtual live streaming hunt for them and for ourselves. Cooper's looking for Super Nintendo games mostly.
Yep.
I'm looking for copies of Wall Street Kid, and everyone else is looking for various popular and rare hard to find games. So let's see what we can find.
Yeah, so I think that this particular video is going to go up while we are still on the trip. So if you hit that link down below and check out his Twitch, you can probably watch us live at these game stores. So
yeah, we'll be live like probably 10-ish more hours a day, every single day. So
it's going to be interesting. It's going to be fun. And yeah, I'm super excited. This is
going to
be awesome.
Where are you looking forward to going?
So I've never been, at least I've never game hunted in Salt Lake City, Vegas, or LA.
Okay, Salt Lake's incredible, so.
So I'm looking forward to that. I've been to all the areas, like just touring with bands,
yeah.
But at the most it's like, hey, the venue's next to a Goodwill, let me pop in real quick. So that's like the extent of what I've been able to do.
You're gonna see some cool stuff then, yeah.
I'm very excited. I'm looking for complete in box Super Nintendo games, but I am also looking for signage, statues, like any really cool
incredibly
stuff like that.
Collectible things.
Yeah, which chances of finding that stuff is pretty low, but you never know. We'll look for it.
We might have something in the back for you, actually, right now.
Maybe we can check that out.
Yes.
So we are starting at Pinkarilla at one of their three locations.
Yeah.
So
working on a fourth, sort of. We'll see.
We might hear about that later.
Retail space pending.
Let's check it out. So I found a couple things at the first stop here that I need. They're from the back, so they don't have prices. And then Cody pulled this out. Didn't know this existed. Ryan would love this.
Let's do it. Sale.
Video inception.
Oh, wait a minute. Gengar Team Ghost is calling an audible. What's up, buddy? What are you after, sir?
This is how it works.
So this is the main thing keeping us from being out of here entirely. It is an incredibly rare arcade machine, and it might look beat up. It's not though. It's actually in incredibly good shape. I've just disassembled it to make it actually fit through that door. So the other interesting thing here is, like, we have this arcade machine, right? But how do you get it out of this building? There's no ramp, there's no elevator, but there is some stairs. For this 600-pound arcade machine.
Yeah, it seems fun.
Yeah, it took six guys to get it in here.
Oh my god. Whew. That's cool, though. So this is the soon-to-be-defunct Pinkarilla storage area.
That's right. Nearly torn down entirely.
You can see there's not too much left in here.
I think all we have in here are posters. The rest might have gotten moved to the new storage unit. Darn. Oh, a Kaldheim Magic set. Perfect. Old bootleg betting tools. That's all in here. Most of it I ended up making in Vegas. Oh, God. I think it's settled into the back.
So cool.
Empty cases. I think all of those are empty cases. And then more bins of, wait, is this that? It's a Commodore clock. Let's see. Yeah, okay. I'm sorry, man.
No, still cool.
Here after all. That sucks. It's just a lot of garbage you need to clear out. Alright, let's see if Al's is open yet.
On to Al's.
We might have to ditch him.
We are at Al's, within walking distance of Pink Gorilla, and they are remodeling. Thinking about getting that one for the store. I just don't know if I want to spend that much money at the second stop. I think I will grab the Bonk's Adventure.
Sick. Oh, he's doing it. Nice.
Well, I want to check it out. Let's stay there. It looks good from the front.
Oh, that's a cool shirt.
You want me to take it out?
Top's good as well. It's got a name carved in the back, but you can always swap the back, so that's not a big deal. Just gotta get more of that back label matches. Freaking Nancy. What a jerk. Yeah, I'll get it.
I can't remember. It was a very low value game. I had a guy who carved his phone number in there, so I just melted it with the soldering iron. But another dude carved his social security number.
What?
In a copy of Breath of Fire on the front page. Like,
why?
Right?
As if someone's gonna use that to somehow contact them when they find the game.
Yeah.
Also, I didn't get to show these yet, but I got these from Cody. They were in his storage thing. My hands were full of holding them, so I couldn't film them. But these are super cool. And they're not for sale.
Yeah, sure.
This is what Cody's got for the list so far. Here we are. Hi-fi, lo-fi.
And it looks freaking sweet. It's a really good look.
It's looking pretty awesome.
Should I get that shirt?
I like that PlayStation logo.
The glare. Unfortunately, I have all of these ones. This is where the dog was last time we came up here and he bit me. We left Hi-Fi Lo-Fi.
I got a bunch of stuff. Kind of.
You got the... Oh, this is my car.
This is his ever car.
We got a copy of Little King Story. And apparently I would like this because it's Pikmin Light.
It is. Yeah. It's the most Pikmin-like game I've ever played. It's not Pikmin. Super
I don't know. Cool. This.
What is this?
Oh.
Zelda.
Zelda? Something
Zoldor?
Yeah. Oh, and Pokemon! Mewtwo Strikes Back. This one broke the bank at $8. But oh, no manual. What the hell?
Alan, I got a t-shirt.
Unfortunately, I didn't find anything there.
Maria Takeuchi. Very cute.
So where's our next stop?
Our next stop is Archie McPhee, which is not a video game store at all. Well, you'll see.
But he said it'll be very interesting, so it'll be cool.
The most interesting store we see.
It'll be cool because normally when we take these trips, we're on such a time crunch that we only hit up the game stores, but we have like a week-long trip, so now we get to go to some cool places. So let's go check it out. Oh, puppy. Wow. They're all pretty cool. Oh my god.
Oh my.
That's awesome. This place is super cool.
Hi everybody. We're a zombie show.
There's some creepy stuff on here. I love it. That's so cool.
That's creepy as shit. Andy's cute. Thank you.
Handy Corgi. Oh, you can get finger hands for finger hands. What?
Twitch chat.
Motog speaks. If those are for sale, I might have to get one for Abby.
Oh, really? Oh, they are. $12.
All right. I found it. Found something for Abby.
Will Dave sell us his collection? Will Dave sell us his store?
I think that it is likely, although it is too soon to tell.
That's very true, actually.
We gotta get down there first. These elephant chairs are so cool. The Wallingford Beast. Look at all the hair. So gross. When are you gonna get? It's a random thing, right?
Okay. No, you pick, but
I'm okay.
Thank you. Have a great rest of your day.
Oh no! Alright, he came out pretty good. Finger puppet.
What? I'm gonna go pay for this.
Sounds good.
Capitol Hill Pink Gorilla. Here we are. Hey. How's it going?
Good.
Going up the stairs. That's a lot.
So you guys have seen this store about a trillion times, but check out what I did find from the road trip requests. Futurama. The
nice.
Xbox we happen to have. CIB inbox.
Heck yeah. So we are at the second Pink Gorilla location. This is the Capitol Hill one. And just looked through some Super Nintendo manuals and I found some that I need. Very excited. Super WrestleMania. NBA Give and Go. I don't actually have this game yet, but this is one that I have looked at on eBay a few times, and it seems like it's kind of hard to find, so I think if I grab the manual now, it'll be easier to get just a box and cartridge later. FIFA Soccer 96 and Brain Lord. Most happy about that one. So, definitely getting those. Let's go take a look at the store. Alright, so from second Pink Gorilla location, grabbed a couple games for Kyle. Got Big Mountain 2000 and Tony Hawk 3, both pretty uncommon titles. And then for my collection, I got the Lego Ninjago Nindroids and got those manuals. And then Super Slapshot for Super Nintendo. Technically, I just needed the manual, but my box is really, really rough. This one looks really good, so it's not only a condition upgrade, but now I also have it complete. So now, we're going to a place called Spin Cycle. Yeah. Yes, 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 we are. We just made it to our next stop, Spin Cycle. Get a shot.
Go for it.
Wow, it has definitely grown since I last saw it. What the heck? You put some serious work into this. And this hole is the only way to get in here? So you like climbed in there to put all these up. This is awesome. We're almost to the next one.
Right there. But here we are at the very first Pink Gorilla.
Goodwill, and then where?
Then we're heading south, so I reckon Super Smash Games in Tacoma. Or you like the Game Bound place?
Yeah.
Yeah, we can go there. That's pretty close. It's kind of south at least. A little micro detour off of I-5. But...
yeah. We were there pretty recently on that last trip up here, but I don't mind stopping in. He usually has a lot of Super Nintendo stuff. Ooh, I'm liking that Zelda Super Nintendo box.
Oh yeah? Oh yeah.
right, so here I picked up Saberwolf for the GBA and Terminator. I paid Cody more than what he had priced on Terminator because he had it too cheap. Don't tell him. This Goodwill is huge, guys. And see that door right there? It's just as big through that door, so it's... This is like four Goodwills in one.
Yo, what do I see there? Yeah, right? It's so massive. You go crazy, you can peek at the other.
All right. This place is huge. I mean, it's like a double-sided toy aisle, but it's also toys on the other side. It's crazy. I'm trying to film as much as I can on the trip. Get a little distracted sometimes and I might forget to film a couple things, but hopefully you guys are enjoying the video so far. I got one DVD and some Reese's things.
I got a pretty good pile going so far.
Nice.
Cooper's pile though, look at that.
All right, so we just got to Game Bound. If you've been watching our videos, you've seen this place. And it's a little bit of a drive with some traffic. And then after here, we're going to, was it Al's is next?
That's right, on Federal Way.
Unfortunately, Super Smash Games is closed today. Both their locations are. So I'm not actually sure what's after Al's.
Super Smash, right?
Super Smash is closed.
Oh, he just said that. We will look it up.
We will figure it out and then we'll let you guys know. Game Over? Oh yeah, Game Over's close to Super Smash, so. But after that, I'm not sure where we're stopping. Eventually, we're just gonna have a long drive all the way back to Vancouver, because there's really nothing in between. But there's one place that Cody wants to stop, but they might be closed, we'll see.
Too.
I like that.
Oh yeah, I have one of those.
600. I was so close to buying one of these last time we came in here. Because they're just so cool.
I like this one a lot, yeah. Well, actually his face, the more I look at it, it looks a little creepy. But yeah, those are good.
And then this thing.
Oh yeah, that's so sick. We used to have one of these guys too. I don't remember what happened.
Sonic, Mega Man, the best one, Donkey Kong, that cool plush I almost bought last time, Kirby, Zelda, more Zelda, and looks like this whole thing is Mario, and then a little bit of Metroid on the bottom.
I got one of the cutest Pikachus in existence, Halloween Pikachu. Cater Pie, looking very derpy. Shinobi 3, CIB.
Ooh.
We got a $70 piece of plastic.
Thank you.
Or cardboard. And two very cheap games to go with it.
I've never seen that.
Yes, it is a very rare variant, or very rare box bundle. And then Need for Speed Most Wanted, pretty uncommon game. And actually, there's two Most Wanteds on the 360. This is the hard to find one.
Sweet. Yeah. Are any of those for you?
Cater Pie.
Nice.
He's too cute.
And I picked up Jeep Jamboree. A couple 3DS games for the collection. Real Fishing 3D Paradise and Nicktoons MLB 3D.
That's how it is on the DS.
And then Barkley Shut Up and Jam. I already had the box, but mine was really rough, so I needed the cartridge and manual anyway. This one's really nice, and it had all the paperwork, the baggie, all that stuff, so very cool. Here we are at the second Al's location. Awesome place, with their very sun-faded Sailor Moon poster.
Ooh,
It's all blue and white now. What'd you get?
Sega Bass Fishing Duel, $7.
Nice.
I mean, flex, excuse me.
And I picked up, finally, two Super Nintendo games I actually need and not just manuals. We got Spin Dizzy Worlds. It's a sealed copy. It looks like a legit seal, but it's a little... questionable, but I'm not really care. It was a really good price. And then Blackthorn, very happy to find that. There's like... some games that I've been looking for that because I'm selling stuff on eBay and you can use your eBay money to buy stuff on eBay. Yeah. So I'll go to the outlet, I'll get a bunch of crap, I'll sell it, and I'll use that money to buy some Super Nintendo games. That's one that I have been searching for on there, but I just can't find it for a good price. So
Blackthorn?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I was happy with
nice
that.
Nice to add an actual good game instead
yeah.
of a lot of whatever.
I got this for Abby. She's going to love it. Little cat bus and all the other little creatures. And then,
I want to see.
Lastly, for the store, got another rare game, Rule of Rose. It was $700. Luckily, we were able to get no tax because we have reseller permits, because the tax would have killed any profit on that. We're not going to make a lot on that game, of course, but I just like having cool stuff for the store.
Yeah.
Because that game never comes in, so might as well get it, and it'll sell right away. I know it will. So nice. We'll make like $100. It's worth it. Woo-hoo. On to the next. On to Game Over.
Game Over, that's right.
So we're in the Tacoma Mall.
Yes, sir.
Game Over Video Games is in here, and then there's a Half Price Books across the street. Stop. You know, we should go there. We stopped at that GameStop last time we were here, and I asked if they had any retro stuff, and he opened a drawer, and I got a bunch of, like, 3DS games and, like, some cool stuff.
Retro? Rude. Well, rude.
He had there. I think I got a couple GameCube games, too. I got a Mario Sunshine.
Okay. All right, let's do it.
Let's go there first.
Sure. It's in front of our face.
I think that the Game Over was down that way, if I remember correctly. They also have a Pokemon card, what do you call them? The Pokemon card, like, vending machine things here.
Oh, cool. I got a really neat
gacha pack right now. Yeah. This place is
pretty cool. Jujutsu Kaisen. Dude, I'm so out of touch with Dragon Ball. Who on earth are these dudes? I mean, I can read, but where the hell are they from?
Pretty awesome. They got Digimon. That's for Jess right there. GameStop first. I'm not gonna film in here because you all know what they look like. And here we are at Game Over. Cody got the Chibi Robo. Yeah. And then I picked up those three at GameStop, but now we're here.
Welcome to Game Over Video Games.
Heck yeah. Let's check it out.
worth a lot more than $100. So
yeah.
Thanks for finding that. Apparently just ask GameStop and they secretly have retro games?
Sometimes.
Okay. Secondly, we found Little League World Series Baseball, which probably sounds pretty dumb to buy, but it is super uncommon. And I have several Twitch viewers who are going for complete 360 sets, so someone will need it.
Yeah. Unfortunately, I didn't find anything at Game Over, but that's all right, because I got those three from GameStop. So now we're on to our last stop of the day, Half Price Books. Half Price Books, last stop of the day. Hopefully we find some goodies. Cody got kicked out for filming. And he didn't find anything, unfortunately. Got the Ni No Kuni.
Oh shit.
Wrath of the White Witch special edition or some sort of edition. This is for Ryan and Jess.
Beautiful.
Pretty cool.
Very shiny.
A lot of the stuff inside is still sealed, so Ryan's happy.
Someone in the chat was saying that that one's, first off, way under price charting. Second, I guess, like, it was one of those things that they oversold and then canceled people's pre-orders on. So.
Oh, dang.
Yeah.
Well, good, kinda because special. It was $175, but after tax, it was like $190 something. So.
Oh, okay. Not as good as ever. Oh, it's still good.
But Ryan and Jess are happy.
Yeah.
Buffalo Willy Wings.
Buffy YYs.
We're going to have some dinner and then we're out of here. All right, guys, it's the next morning.
This is the craziest game room I've ever seen. Insane, man.
So we got back last night and we hung out here for a little bit. He was looking around and we were chatting and stuff, and this morning I was like, man, we should have filmed something in the game room.
No, what have I done?
Don't worry, the guns are a little sticky. There's like that weird kind of like rubber that, you know, kind of like breaks down. Like, yeah,
PS2 controllers. Yeah,
yeah, a little bit.
Yeah, this is wild, man.
But yeah, I was like, man, we should have filmed something last night. And so we're about to leave for the day, but I wanted to get at least, you know, some sort of clip, because it was so funny last night. He was like, look around and be like, oh, what is this? This is so crazy.
This is something I've never seen before. And I've been doing this for like 15 years or something. This is crazy, man. You're a next level collector.
I was asking him last night if he ever gets the itch to collect. And you're like, maybe like a full 360 set or something. And then when we got back here, I was like, and after he like looked around for a while, I was like, the reason I asked is because I've had other people who don't collect, who will see the game room and then kind of get the itch to maybe start collecting.
Yeah, we'll see. Maybe when I get back to my house, I'll start like eyeing different walls and seeing what's possible. But not this.
Well, are you ready to start today?
Yes. Start at double jump.
All right, so we're
fixing this gun.
So today we are doing double jump legendary games, hidden treasures, total, which is they're closed, but they're luckily going to be there doing inventory, so they're going to let us in. And then Hawthorne Game Exchange and I think Video Game Wizards. If we somehow have extra time, we can maybe find one more spot, but our plane's a little early, so we'll see.
Oh yeah.
Let's get going.
Tomorrow.
Heck yeah, let's go. All right, guys, we made it to our first stop. This place isn't even open today.
You broke in.
Here you go.
Oh, that cabinet's on though. Well, here we are.
It looks so good.
Abby's joining us today. And we're at Hidden Treasures, which we haven't been to for a little bit.
They're closed Mondays and Tuesdays now.
What?
What?
Oh wait, I think it was.
Mondays and Tuesdays.
Didn't you just talk to her?
Yeah.
And you told her like we were coming and stuff?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sadness.
Call her.
I also talked
to her. No, she's got kids.
Call, just ask. Maybe Absolutely. They're inside. The lights are on. See, I see it.
Weekend.
Man!
It'll be okay.
Alright.
I guess we're off to Legendary. Here we are. Sad we couldn't go to Hidden Treasures, but we still got Legendary. And then after this, we're heading into Portland. This is the one that we have at home. Cody was talking about.
Those are our last two.
I remember seeing other ones, but I didn't see these. I must have missed them. But we had like eight of them, I think.
This one's so cool.
Looking for
still
shipwrecked. Yeah,
I'll never find it.
These guys,
so
one of them
Abby
is
got these.
Partially decapitated. His name is Nearly Headless Nick.
Little hometown story plushies. And then
Rogue Spear.
This is just a game we didn't have. And then this one, we technically only needed the manual, but he didn't want to separate it, which I completely understand. And it's really cheap, and the cartridge is an upgrade. So
okay.
The box might be, I'm not sure. According to my spreadsheet, this seems like it might be pretty similar to our box, but either way, we knocked another manual off the list.
Congrats.
Cody didn't find anything here, unfortunately. But now we're going into Portland, and what's our first stop? Hawthorne?
Yeah.
Which one's the most north?
Well, I don't know my direction.
We'll see when we get there. Next stop, VGW, Video Game Wizards, in Portland. See guys, Portland's not that bad. Everyone always comments on the videos, they're like, Portland's so crazy, there's riots and looting, it's all on fire. No, it's not.
There's some crazy
Look.
Videos.
It's as safe and as dangerous as any other city is.
Pretty much. Let's see what we can find here. We haven't been here in a while. We went to the Malala location last time we went to one, but we haven't been here for many months. After you, good sir. They have that countertop, Master Chief. I always want that one.
Look, there's a teal system down there.
Ooh, and a Game Boy camera. Love these Sega cabinets. We just saw one the other day and at a like antique mall, but it was not for sale. So sad. Yeah, they've remodeled in here since last time we were in here. Like all this stuff that's over here was not here before. It's really cool. Here's what I'm picking up. We got a couple games for the store. The Wild Arms 3 is for Kyle. This is the one complete Super Nintendo game they had that I needed. Happy about that. They had Skulljagger, but doesn't have a manual. And then I've got these 3DS games for the collection as well. Nothing too crazy. Just some cheap titles. And when he scanned them in, a couple of the prices went down, which is pretty cool.
There you are. All right, everybody.
What
we got
get?
Shadow of Aku for $50 on the PS2. We got a Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening DX for $50.
Was that on the list?
Yep. Yes. Well, there were two on the list. So, yeah.
Sweet.
We got Metroid 2 Return of Samus with a beautifully replaced back. We got a Golden Sun again. No. This one's not missing the manual. So now we have both of the Golden Suns. So,
sweet.
Beautiful. Conker's Bad Fur Day in really, 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 really good shape. Every last aspect of it is. I think it's complete. You would know better, but it's got a precautions book and something else. Some kind of ad. Indiana Jones. They do this like thing. It's a little weird, but I mean, works for me. They like rang it up. I was like, okay, I'm gonna buy these two. And they go, okay, this is $1 less. I'm like, oh, okay, cool, I'll take it. We also had two Wall Street Kids.
Wow.
Yes. At a low price too, $13.
Adopting more children.
What does Wall Street Kid normally go for?
Now the average is like between 15 and 20. So we have Mario Party 9. That was 53. We have the Legend of Legaia book, which is pretty beat up, but it's... Oh, look, he has a mustache.
Made of dirt.
It's pretty beat up, but it's like half of what the person was willing to pay for it. So it's like, that's a pretty good trade-off. And lastly, a Fallout 3 game guide, which is pretty sick. Looks like it's in... Yeah, it's beat up a little bit, but... All the Sweet. Pages are there, it seems. But yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, good stuff. Thanks
cool, so... We're going to Hawthorne next. So you said you wanted to kind of try to do like one tourist thing per stop, per area. We have two stores left that we can hit, Hawthorne and Total. Then there's the Penny thing, but there's also a movie store in Portland called Movie Madness, and it's like super famous. They have like a bunch of movie props and like all sorts of cool stuff. It's right by Hawthorne.
Let's do that.
If you want to do that.
Yeah, that sounds fun.
All right, let's go. Welcome, welcome. Nintendo Power.
Nintendo Power.
Hopefully we find a few more things on the list.
Okay, sure. So we got a really, really nice looking Jurassic Park on the Game Boy there.
Awesome.
We got a Jet Grind radio, super duper complete. Only bad thing is a teeny little bump over there, but you know what? You display it like that or that, nobody's gonna know the better. We got a DDR Quintamix, Donkey Kong Country 3, Dixie Kong's a Double Trouble.
That one looks like it's a really nice condition.
Yeah, pretty much perfect. Link to the Past, Game Secrets, and Dragon. These were all bought for Twitch viewers, so they all approved the conditions. I mean, how can you not?
And then I got Isabelle faceplates for 3DS, and then Blaze Blue Continuing Shift 2 for 3DS. And now...
That was a cheap-ass game, but it'll sneak up on you.
Now, I think we're gonna maybe grab some food real quick, and then we're gonna head to Total.
Yes.
And then... Oh, yeah. We'll figure it out. Pepino's. Love this place. I'm gonna get a quesadilla. Oh yeah. Green. The green. No, we already got one. It's okay. That was fine. This place is so good. We're sitting right by the opening. It's all nice. We got our waiting for the food.
Check in.
No. Going down.
All right, guys.
It just came down and opened that much.
I think we went around the block. Like, because there's Payless. We pulled it down there, didn't we?
And actually, you can see the
It's the sign's right here. Maybe it's inside here. This is where we're going.
Where's the list?
Can't pull my arms down.
Oh yeah. This place is awesome.
Which one are we gonna get first? So we got, oh nice, perfect, Oregon one. Made in Oregon, got a rocket fizz, got a bridge, and which one is that?
Probably Mount Rainier. Oh, it's so cool. Hey, those aren't all Pokemon.
And
what's that? That's Dragon Ball. That's a Baby Yoda. And we got all these awesome arcade machines. Turtles in Time, Street Fighter, Star Wars and Terminator 2 Pinball. This is awesome. That is so cool. One day, guys. One day for a future game room, we'll get one of these. Finger hands for your finger hands. We gotta show Cody. Finger hands for your finger hands.
Yeah,
we just arrived at Total. They're closed to do inventory today, but luckily they said we can come in anyway and do our shopping. And this is going to be our last stop. Well, our last game store. We have one more stop. But this is our last game store in Portland because we have a plane to catch this evening. And this is going to be awesome. And hopefully we find some cool stuff. This is our friend's store.
I know we will.
So it's going to be awesome. Let's go inside. Inventory day. Hudson Hawk. Is that sealed?
Very integral.
I think it is. Here's what we're looking for. And I have all these. Dang it. I have them. So sad. Ooh, House of the Dead 2.
Oh, sweet.
That's pretty awesome. And Primal Rage. And Simpsons. Here it is, Snake.
Sick, so
you got one thing, right?
Yeah, it's hiding in here, it's our can of hearts.
Arcana heart for PS2. Unfortunately, I didn't find anything. Abby, did you get something?
I got Dr. Pepper and Ghost Pepper gummies.
Delicious.
Hard candy, they're not gummies.
Oh,
it's
they felt
like
gummy.
Comically hot, like unpleasantly hot?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Probably.
Okay,
probably.
I'll stay away from that.
I mean, it'd be comical to somebody. No, but I really want to. Nice.
So now we are headed to Movie Madness.
I'm so excited.
And then that'll be it for today. Here we are, never been here before. Movie Madness. You can return your tapes right here. Help they allow filming.
Michelle. Yeah, that's gonna be like one of my favorite animated shows.
It's so awesome.
Well, a little more grounded though.
What?
This place is so awesome. Holy crap. Look at all these movie props. Austin Powers outfits. This is so freaking cool. Look at all these.
It's like what? Pretty iconic.
The what? Actual brick from the logo?
That's a bar of soap, but yeah.
Oh, that is so awesome.
What?
This place is really, really cool. I'm so glad we stopped here.
Yeah, right?
This is awesome.
This is a good capper.
Freaking alien head.
There's also...
Is this...
It says right here, the actual alien warhead designed by Stan Winston for James Cameron's 1986.
Cody, did you see the actual alien head in here? That's so cool.
I think I glossed over because I got excited about Fight Club. But yeah.
That's like, people consider that to be like the best movie ever made.
Yeah.
That's so crazy.
Have you seen it?
I haven't seen it. I told you, I'm not a movie guy, but this is awesome.
I did watch it.
Was it good?
Yes, great. Not my favorite.
The original Locket.
What?
Oh, from Castaway, yeah. Oh.
This is my favorite stop. Even though we're probably not going to buy anything, but this is just awesome. They have an actual movie theater in here too. This is awesome.
Oh my god.
It's from Mars Attacks. Even though we can't buy anything here, this is probably my favorite stop of the day. This is just so crazy. Well, this is kind of weird. This entire section looks sun faded, but I don't think it is. You can come here and rent the Super Mario Brothers movie. That is so cool. All right, guys, we're at the airport and we're pretty much gonna end the video here because we're about to find some food and then catch a flight to Salt Lake City, Utah. And we'll pick up again at the beginning of the next video. And we have a lot more to do. So I hope you guys enjoyed this first part. That seems crazy, but I'm excited. Hope you guys are. Hope you enjoyed this first part of our game hunting road trip. And we'll see you guys in the next video in Salt Lake City. Peace.